Welcome to Columbia University. My name is Connor Abamonte. I'm an alumnus of this university, a veteran of the United States Navy, and a member of the Next Step Inbound team. Today, Next Step Inbound has partnered with Columbia University's Center for Veteran Transition and Integration. We're going to take you around this year college, show you what it's like to be a student veteran in Columbia University in the city of New York. Founded in 1754, Columbia University is the oldest institution of higher learning here in the state of New York, and the fifth oldest in the United States of America. Columbia is home to 31,000 students, 8,800 of whom are undergraduates. And in 1947, Columbia University started the School of General Studies to cater to World War II veterans who, backed by their GI Bills, were stoked to start their undergraduate endeavors. Today, GS is home to everyone from Olympic ice dancers, ballerinas, and most importantly, nearest and dearest to my heart, military veterans. GS students take the same courses, study with the same faculty, and major in the same departments, and are held to the same high standards as all other Columbia undergraduates, be they from Columbia College, the Foo School of Engineering, or Barnard College. You take the same classes, you get the same grades, and you get the same degrees. Well, New York City can be a vibrant and oftentimes loud city. Our campus is relatively quiet, with the exception of those screaming youths. However, if you do need even more quiet, you can go to one of Columbia's many libraries.
Some of the more iconic ones are Lowe and Butler Library, Columbia's largest library. But there's a total of 17 different libraries on campus for students to use, which, of course, is why Columbia is recognized as having one of the top five academic research library systems in North America. You can catch students doing everything from studying with friends, to writing essays, to leisurely reading in any of the libraries.
One of the coolest classrooms here on campus is this, Havemeyer 309. It's been featured in everything from Spider-Man to Malcolm X to the West Side Story. About 10 blocks north from here, you can find Columbia University's Manhattanville campus, which is home to the newly redesigned business school.
The campus encompasses more than 17 acres and includes publicly accessible open space, tree-lined sidewalks, and innovative buildings. On campus, you can do everything from grabbing a cup of coffee with friends to rock climbing between classes. Also, a sweet perk to know about is that undergraduate students can actually take classes at the new business school, granting them access to a curriculum that so few get to experience.
Now, when it comes to profound locations across campus, people generally think of Butler Library, Lowe Library, but behind me stands Lewiston Hall, home to the GS Lounge. Let's go check it out. The GS Lounge is a great space for student vets, or any student that's part of the GS community, to study, collaborate, or work on various projects, or simply hang out. Additionally, the GS Lounge will host various events throughout the year. But to see one of the biggest event spaces on campus, we have to head over to Lerner Hall. Right next to Butler Library is Lerner Hall. Lerner Hall happens to be home to my favorite dining hall on campus, Ferris Booth Commons, and is home to some of the biggest event spaces on campus, including where they hold weekly MilVets meetings. MilVets president, Grayson Noyce, happens to be waiting for us upstairs. Let's go meet up with him. MilVets was originally founded in 2002 by a group of students at the School of General Studies. Today, MilVets continues to be a great asset and community for all service members. Grayson.
Hey, Connor, how are you?
So good to see you, dude.
Please step into my office.
Oh, absolutely. After you.
Thank you.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov.
Grayson, thank you so much for joining us today, man.
Absolutely, Connor.
So before we begin, do you mind telling us a little bit about your military service and how you got to Columbia University?
Sure. I served 4 years in the Marine Corps as a military police officer.
Same here.
Absolutely. Very cool. Spent 2 years in Okinawa, Japan on Camp Hansen. From there, went on missions to Mongolia, Philippines, and South Korea. And then spent the last year of my service in San Diego.
So you are the president of Columbia University's MilVets group. Do you mind telling us a little bit about MilVets?
Absolutely. You know, so MilVets is the student organization for all of the veterans at Columbia. with a specific focus on the 500 or so undergraduate veterans currently at the School of General Studies. We advocate for veterans' needs, we facilitate a successful education, and really our focus is to transition veterans into collegiate society and ensure that they succeed afterwards too in professional and corporate society.
What's just one thing you want to share with the audience?
I think that if you are considering coming to Columbia University, I think it is a really unique and special community. You are right in the center of the financial hub of the world with so many opportunities. Living in New York City and attending Columbia University, especially as a veteran, is such an invigorating experience. And I know that it may be intimidating during the application process, but just realize you have people to help you. You have organizations that will advocate for you, and everything will work out how it's supposed to.
Grayson, this has been really informative, and I'm sure you've helped a lot of people who are considering applying here. Thanks again, man.
Absolutely.
And in case you were wondering, no, Columbia doesn't require military veterans to live in the dorms during their freshman year. In fact, the GI Bill or Voc Rehab will provide you with a monthly housing allowance, which is E5BAH in New York City. It's enough to live in New York pretty comfortably. Trust me, I did it for 4 years.
Columbia University also offers various benefits that are applicable to student vets. Whether it be mental health services through the Center of Counseling and Psychological Services, the disability services offered by the Disability Department, or academic assistance through writing workshops which are hosted at the Writing Center on campus.
One of the best resources are the professors here at Columbia. So now, let's go chat with a couple of them. Professor O'Flaherty, thank you so much for joining us today. Before we begin, do you mind telling us about what you teach here at Columbia and how long you've been a part of the faculty?
I teach economics. I do principles of economics, urban economics, economics of race, and a few other topics. I've been here since 1987.
Awesome. And in your time that you've been here, how would you say that veterans differentiate themselves in your classroom compared to their traditional 18-year-old fresh out of high school counterparts?
Well, there are a lot more veterans now than when I started, and I think that's progress. They come with much more experience. They're much more eager to learn things, to make progress.
So I would say that military vets, of whom I've had a few, both here and at other schools, tend to be older, of course, more experienced, more mature. And it's always nice to have more experienced, more mature students in the class. They bring a whole different perspective to the class.
I find that veterans, when they come into the class, have a wealth of experiences, some of which are different from the experiences of their classmates,
sure.
And they add to a really rich mix in conversation.
Has anyone ever had, you know, a family, children, any of the other, you know, milestones of life that come with being an older student?
Of
and
course.
How have those students either benefited or survived in a college environment? Because those can get in the way, I know from experience.
Right, older students, military vets, as well as other older students, of course have more things going on in their lives. They have family, they have jobs often. And on the one hand, I think they can almost juggle better than a younger student because they're more mature. But also, of course, I think I and other professors as well, of course, we want to know about that sort of thing, and we will do what we can to accommodate.
I support students who have kids of their own. I have kids of my own. I'm sympathetic to the incredible demands of parenthood.
What advice would you give to somebody in the military community considering applying to college?
I mean, not really different from what I would give. The advice I would give to somebody in the military community doesn't differ that much from what I would give to anybody. When you write your application, for example, make sure that you talk about your personal experience, what makes you different. And for a vet, obviously that's something that makes them different from the average college applicant.
It's a really like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to think differently and to take the time to focus on questions that you really care about, and to gain skills and to learn how to think differently. And it's always worth it.
Professor Cooper, thank you so much for your time today. It's been incredibly informative and helpful for the military community.
Thank you for inviting me. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much for your time, Professor. We genuinely appreciate it. It's been very informative.
Of course.
Everything that you want is here. Just go get it.
And now we're going to have a conversation with the Vice Dean of the School of General Studies, Dean Curtis Rogers. Let's go.
His experience working with military service members and veterans over the last 20 years led to his founding, along with the late Dean Peter J. Ahn, the Center for Veteran Transition and Integration. And today, we're thrilled to have the ability to chat with him. Dean Rogers, thank you so much for your time today.
Of course.
If you don't mind, I'm gonna ask you a couple questions. Sorry I have cold, dead hands right now. My hand has been out in this extreme cold for the last like 15 minutes. First question I have for you is, what do you admire most about the veteran community here at Columbia?
Thank you for having me. I admire the same thing I admire about all of our students at Columbia University. It's the contribution made in the classroom, the contribution to the intellectual discourse. Columbia University has a school dedicated to non-traditional students where most of our student veterans attend. It's a school designed for non-traditional students who follow a non-traditional path, and it's based on the idea that experience matters, that experience informs what you want to think about, what you want to write about, what you want to actually contribute in the classroom, and having student veterans in the classroom contributing based on their experiences during their time in service as enlisted women and men who signed up to, you know, to serve the nation, drawing on that, bringing that into the classroom, bringing that into the academic conversation is really one of the most valuable contributions they can make.
Love it. Awesome. Okay, cool. Next question. Overall, when concerning the academic performance of student veterans, how do you think student veterans perform when compared to the traditional student directly out of high school?
It's an interesting question because I sort of step back from that and I don't see a difference. Now, I say that knowing all students are different. They come in with their own backgrounds, their own academic and classroom experiences. But when we look at populations across the spectrum, the contributions made and the performance that we see is as good as any other student at a highly competitive place like Columbia University. They thrive, they excel, they succeed, and they're probably disproportionately represented at the tops of the academic ranks within all of the units, the academic departments that they're enrolled in.
Cool. I really appreciate your time today. Thank you so much for meeting with us and taking time to answer some more questions.
Yeah, of course.
Sweet.
Thank you.
One of the best parts about being here in Columbia, say in New York City, there's endless bars, restaurants, places to hang out. Locations such as Blue Bottle Coffee, Amity Hall Uptown, Arts and Crafts Beers, or the staple of the Milbets community, Mel's Burger Bar on 110th. If you want to get away from campus, you're arguably in the best place on earth to do so, because New York is full of a lot of attractions, be it Times Square, Central Park, Grand Central Station, Statue of Liberty, Financial District, Broadway, or endless bars, rooftops, or adventures. But don't be fooled. Columbia puts on some amazing events for GS members throughout the year, such as the GS Gala and the Columbia Military Ball, which caters specifically to the student veteran community here on campus. Don't just take it from me, though. Let's introduce you to some of the student veterans here on Columbia's campus and see what they have to say about it as well. So to begin, do you mind telling us about your military service? What branch were you in? What was your job?
Yes, I was in the United States Navy, and I was medically retired in 2015, so I served for 5 years.
For the 5 years, I was in 1st Battalion, 75th Ranger Regiment.
I was in the Marine Corps.
I was in the Marine Corps for 5 years, active duty. I was a 6694.
I spent 22 years in the United States Army as an infantry officer.
Did you face any challenges when you first showed up here on campus?
Yes, I did, because I am a commuting student and I'm also a parent. So one of the challenges that I faced was getting to know other people and having some peers that I could depend on emotionally as well as academically. What really helped me with that was MilVets and knowing the other veterans, and they were able to kind of relate to my experience as well.
How do you think you found community here at Columbia?
Yeah, that was a huge worry for me, trying to rebuild, friend groups, but like, how could I be connected, as connected to somebody at college as I was, in a squad back on the line. And so one of the reasons I came to Columbia was because of how many veterans were here, and I thought that that would be kind of a good transition.
When you first got here, did you ever expect to have like a conversation or exchange or office hours or a relationship with a professor like that where you can, kind of have that like eyes wide open experience that like, you're like, oh wow, you are right. This is going to change the way that I approach something.
I think I came here with the opinion that school was pointless and I hated school because of my past experience with it. Mm-hmm. I feel almost grateful for doing 12 years in the military because now I appreciate learning for what it is. Like, it's no more about getting the check in the box. It's like, wow, I want to do this because it's interesting and I'm curious.
What advice would you give the E4, the E5, the 20-year E7 who's, you know, done with the military and is considering a school like Columbia or just considering college in general?
I think my biggest piece of advice would be to not self-select. So do not think that just because you may not come from a background that has set you up for an Ivy League education, do not self-select yourself out of it. I'm a firm believer today, like as I stand here right now, that anything is possible. You need to take that leap. You need to take that jump and believe in yourself and
tap into the resources of the people who have already transitioned before you. Mm-hmm. Figure out what they did, figure out how they tailored their resumes.
What would you recommend for those enlisted folks who have that mindset of college isn't for me and they're coming up to the end of their enlistment?
When I did Warrior Scholar Project, I came here and I was like nervous that the staff would judge me for like being this like dumb Marine that's covered in tattoos. And the reality was so much different. And like, I had all these preconceived notions that like, these people are so much smarter than me. Like, I don't belong at a school like this. Like the Ivy League seemed like this unreachable goal. And then I get here and it's almost like, wow, I was so wrong. Like, I do have value. I do have things to add here.
What advice would you have for any junior enlisted or any enlisted person?
The government's helping you to do something hard with a lot of financial assistance that most people would, you know, you should really recognize just what asset you have in the GI Bill. And understand that with it comes a little bit of responsibility because we're asking you to continue your studies. We're asking you to be a better person. We're asking you to use the GI Bill to get educated and figure out what your next chapter is going to be and then to do great with it. And that requires some growth and some learning. So, dive in. Don't be intimidated by it and recognize it's going to be a hard journey.
You're getting paid to be here. There's no reason not to. Even if it doesn't work, at least make your own mind up. Like that 4 year, if you did 4 years and got out, like those 4 years changed something in you. And when you get an environment like this where you're like learning things that you care about and like, it's fun and you're paid to do it.
Don't discount yourself. Don't sell yourself short. I'm a first generation student, so coming to an Ivy League was definitely not something that I thought I could do. But take a chance on yourself and you never know where you'll end up.
We hope you enjoyed this tour of Columbia University in the city of New York. And if you'd like to see NSI host more tours like this on other college campuses, let us know in the comments. And finally, if you like our merch, let us know. We're thinking of making some more. Till next time.